My name is Dr. Steve Cohen. I'm a plastic surgeon in La Jolla, California. I am well known internationally for my work. We have an amazing practice. We've been working with the same group of laser providers, estheticians, and support staff for many years. We're here to take care of you, and today we're going to talk a little about a very popular subject in the press, Brazilian butt lift, or the BBL. It's become a fashion trend in many countries in the world. I want to just generally talk about our approach and some of the important safety considerations that we have to take to make this an outstanding operation. First of all, not everybody wants a large buttock, but most people want a shapely and a youthful buttock. And there are different ways of looking at this, both in women and increasingly even in men. We begin to look at how does the buttock age? How does it change shape? Liposuction truly is a sculptural procedure. When you evaluate somebody who comes in for reshaping of their flanks and their inner and outer thighs, one of the requests that come up is buttock augmentation. What we're looking at is how do you shape the back? How do you create the transition into the buttock area? How do you preserve the little venous dimples in the back that are really a hallmark of beauty, and how do you do this in a subtle way that addresses the patient's ethnic background and their personal taste, and yet still provides a very safe and outstanding result? First of all, fat grafting. Fat grafting, if you've read about this more recently to the buttock, is associated with some dangerous issues. There have been a slew of deaths reported. The fat can be injected into veins that are below the muscle, and the muscle can be torn, fat will end up in these veins, or the fat can inadvertently be injected into the veins if they're torn by the liposuction cannula. In order to avoid that, the space that the fat is placed in is above the muscle. We never put fat in the muscle, and we have techniques that involve vibration in order to accommodate the placement of fat in an area that is below the skin, but well above the muscle. We've never had an issue with any kind of fat getting into a blood vessel. It's very important that people take this into consideration. At certain ages, you begin to lose fat over the bone of the hip. Their buttock begins to drop and sag to some extent. And the way we do this procedure now is by carving out the flanks and carving out the central region above the buttock. You begin to shape the buttocks. They rise like mounds from the surrounding tissue because you've reduced the surrounding tissue. So one of the key components is sculpting the figure in a way that the buttock look bigger right from the outset. This way we don't have to put a lot of fat in. We can put fat in the key areas, over the bone, on the side, and opposite the bones where the maximum projection of the buttock is. So all of these normal locations and understanding of normal anatomy are critical to providing individual patients with great outcomes. And the other thing you have to remember, in a practice like ours, we're dealing with a lot of variation in tastes. And you have some people who really are looking for a very full buttock area. In other patients, they're looking for a shapely buttock. It's still applying the same principles. We account for all of these individual variations, because really what we're doing is artwork, but with reality. And we're highly considerate of your desires, but also highly considerate of safety when it comes to any procedure done in our practice, Faces Plus.